Hello everyone and welcome. In this video, we're going to take a look at how we can use direct blueprint communication to communicate between several blueprints or directly between two blueprints. So let's take a look at what we're going to do. We have the blueprint first person template up with starter content enabled. We're going to need to create some blueprints really quickly. So I'm going to hop down to the starter content folder and let's go to the shapes folder. Let's use a shape cube. I'm going to right click on my shape cube here under asset actions, going to create a blueprint using this. The default name is fine and creating a blueprints folder is fine. I'm going to hop back to the level really quickly and create another blueprint out of the shape sphere here. So I'm going to right click on that, asset actions, create blueprint using this, and save it in that same location. And there we go. So now we have a shape cube. If I stop auto-saving, we have a shape cube and a shape sphere. I'm going to hop back to the level really quickly and go back into the blueprints folder that was just created. There are our two blueprints. I'm going to left click and drag in my shape sphere. I'm going to left click and drag in my shape cube. Now what we want to have happen is when the player overlaps this shape sphere, it's going to send a signal to this cube to move it up along the Z. So directly communicating from this blueprint to this blueprint to move up. So let's go ahead and do that. We're going to hop to the shape cube first, and we're going to hop to the event graph, right-clicking and dragging to hide the default nodes because we're not going to use those. I'm going to right-click on the graph and create a custom event here. Custom event here. And I'm going to call this the move up event. And this custom event will be called from our shape sphere blueprint in a moment. First thing we need to do, hold control and drag in a static mesh. Drag in our static mesh component and drag off of it and add local offset is what we're looking for. So with that selected, let's connect the executable out to the in. And on the Z, we're going to change this to a 50. So add 50 to our current location each time this custom event is called. So with that, let's compile and save. Let's hop over to the shape sphere blueprint now and to the event graph. Right, clicking and dragging those nodes off the screen because we don't want those. We're going to use our own. First thing we need to do, though, is select our static mesh. And in the details panel, need to make sure that we are not set to block all dynamic and collision because we want to make sure that only the player pawn, overlap only pawn, is selected so that the player character can pass through this static mesh and create overlap events. So with that, I'm going to right click and search for overlap. And scroll up. Let's just use the add on component begin overlap. We could use the actor, but for the sake of it, let's just use on component because we're referring to our static mesh. Now with that, there's one thing we need to do before we continue. We need to create a brand new variable. So I'm gonna hop over to the variables tab or the My Blueprint window in the variable section, click the new variable button. We're gonna call this variable the mover signal. Now in the details panel, there's some things we need to change really quickly for this blueprint. I'm going to click the variable type dropdown and search for shape cube. So we're looking for our shape cube blueprint. That is the blueprint that we just created. So let's go ahead and select that. And let's make sure that this variable is publicly editable. So with that, let's hold control and drag in our variable here, which is referring to a shape cube. Let's first of all make sure that the shape cube is valid. So is valid. Go ahead and select this one. And let's connect the executable out to the end. And if it is not, if this object is not valid, don't do anything. But if it is valid, we're going to drag off of this one more time and call that function that we created in it, which was called the move up event, like so. And connect that like so. So when we overlap this static mesh, make sure that this object is indeed valid. If it is, call the move up event inside this blueprint. If I double click on move up event, it takes me to that custom event, which is our other blueprint. And what it is going to do is move our static mesh up along the Z 50 units. So let's hop into the editor here. Let's actually make sure I compiled really quickly just for the sake of it and save. Let's hop into the editor here and play. And let's find our sphere here. Now you would think that this would work. Everything looks good in our blueprint. Let's test it out. I move into it and it does not move our cube. Now why is that? Let's take a look why that is. So we have our sphere here and we have our cube, and we are directly communicating from this sphere to this cube. If I select my sphere here and you look in the details panel, for the mover signal that we created, that variable, it is pointing to none. And it is pointing to none, even though we specified a variable, we need to say which instance of our shape cube blueprint we are referring to. So if I hold Alt and drag out a copy of this, this is why we need to specify an instance. So if I click this little eyedropper here, it says pick actor from scene. I can click it, and inside the level, now I can select which instance of that blueprint we want to affect. So let's go ahead and select this one. And now if I play and go over to my cube here, watch what happens. Only the left one moves up because we specified that instance as being the one to affect. So with that, you've learned how to directly communicate from one blueprint to another. We didn't specify that we want to talk to this blueprint. So what we need to do now, if we want to communicate with multiple blueprints, we can do that a little bit differently. So let's hop over to our shape sphere blueprint here. And what we're going to do is actually, let's delete all of this. So I'm just going to left click and drag and delete that and delete this, because we are not referring to one specific instance. We're going to refer to multiple of them. And there's a handy little node. If we right click and we search for get all actors of class, there it is at the top. Get all actors of class finds all actors in the world of the specified class. So I'm going to go ahead and select that and connect our executable to that. And for our actor class, we can now specify the shape cube blueprint that we created. And we're going to drag out, drag off the out actors, which is an array of all the actors that it gets. So we're going to drag off this and add a for each loop node. So it's saying for each of the actors that we get, let's connect this executable before we forget. For each of the actors that we get, if we drag off of this now the array element, this is the actual instance that it pulls out, we can say move up event. So let's connect like so. So for each one that it gets, it's going to call this move up event. Now let's compile and save. And let's hop back into the editor. And we can see now that if we, well, actually, let's, for the sake of it, hop to our shape sphere. And let's kill this mover signal variable because we're not even using it anymore. So let's go ahead and just kill it for the sake of clarity. And save and hop back to our level. Now that option is gone from our details panel, which we don't need it anyway. So I'm gonna hold Control and select both my shape cubes here, then hold Alt to create a copy. Gonna hold Control to select all four, hold Alt to drag out another copy. Now we have all these cubes in here. We're gonna hit play to play in the editor. Now they should all move up along 50 units, boop, which they do. So there you go, you have learned how to communicate from one blueprint directly to another, as well as one blueprint to all blueprints of a particular class. We hope you enjoyed this video, and we will see you next time.